As a senior officer in overseas secret intelligence, he still liked to see for himself what was happening around the world, while of course maintaining his contacts. Politicians, business leaders and fellow intelligence officers with whom he'd become friendly over the previous two decades were similarly reaching the pinnacle of their professions and their influence. To turn over those personal contacts entirely to other officers would be, in his view, to risk diminishing the sway he held. Brian Stewart, a colleague going back to Malaya days, compared Morris with Dick White, and in his view the differences between the two were marked. Sir Dick White often said to me that he envied me my field experience. Despite the flamboyant title of his biography, The Perfect English Spy, he was fundamentally an intelligence bureaucrat, not an operator. Morris Oldfield, on the other hand, after a short spell in academia, spent most of his career in the field and was the Mandarin's favourite intelligence chief. Sir Dick did not have the same people knack and confidence as Morris, or the personal contacts all over the world. With his new appointment, Morris set about arranging his life around it. For the next 14 years, his trips to Derbyshire would become more frequent, generally about once a month, though endlessly variable, and he would use those times, as White had advised, to temporarily free his mind from his work. Sometimes he would bring guests back with him, colleagues usually, and he would always be accompanied by Ken Dyer. In those days, he was able to move with relative freedom, usually arriving by train and being collected from Bakewell Station by John or Warren Pearce. Their car was registered with the police as Morris's official vehicle. Betty Kemp was a regular visitor to Overhaddon, as was Tony Cavendish. Both appreciated the peace Morris enjoyed there and would continue to visit long after he died. He was often to be found in the Lathkill, enjoying halves of bitter and spinning tales nobody could ever remember. A close friend in the service said of Morris, "It was very obvious to us that his family and Derbyshire were what he lived for."